Thank you. ॐ नमो भगवते
And how husband and wife can cooperate together, and by helping each other, they can make spiritual advancement.
然后丈夫与妻子可以来好好的互相合作，可以得到灵性的进步。
We spoke also about the role of Lord Shiva, how Lord Shiva is very compassionate on the people in the mode of ignorance, and particularly in relation to ghosts, and how he delivers them.
然后我们想到挺Shiva的这个角色，他是这么的怜悯，然后对这个在愚昧属性的生物是特别怜悯，那尤其是这些鬼魂们。
And then we also pointed out Lord Shiva's example, how he's completely detached from all material circumstances. He has no consideration about his own well-being.
然后又说到希瓦是完全的弃绝，没有去想到他自己的个人的利益福祉。
And at the same time, he's compassionate on people.
不只是弃绝，同时又是所有的被生物都怜悯。
So we pointed out the negative and positive actions of Didi, how she performed acts which were. On one hand, she had created, made everything inauspicious, but on the other side, there were some positive aspects in her actions, and that was to her benefit.
然后我们说到这个Diti呢，她的正面跟负面的特质，就是说在一方面呢，她造成了这个不吉祥的后果，然后另一方面的正面就是说她有一些良好的品质。
Negative aspects were her disobedience to the instructions of her husband and apathy to the demigods. Negative aspects of
Diti. Diti她的罪，这个在她负面的情况里面，就是说她违背了这一些半日神人的，忽略他们的存在。
And she didn't give proper regard to religious principles and to what was the auspicious and inauspicious time.
然后呢，就是说呢，她这样对半神不尊敬，然后去忽略了行为方面的恰当的时间。
On the positive side, she lamented for her actions and she was penitent also.
他的正面方面呢，就是说他领悟他后悔他犯的错误，那同时他也自己来做一些忏悔。She
had faith in the Supreme Lord, and she also had very good regard for Lord Shiva.
那么他对主也是有很大的尊敬跟信心，然后对Shiva也是很尊崇的。
So the results of her negative aspect was that she had two children who were of demonic character.
那么他错误的结果呢，就是生了两个恶魔性格的孩子。
And the two sons would terrorize the universe, and they give trouble to innocent women, and they would generally create havoc for all God-conscious people.
他的两个儿子是那么邪恶呢，然后就是去骚扰无辜的人们，然后造成宇宙的动荡，还有去侵犯女子们哈。
But because of her positive aspects of her action, because of the good side of Diti, the result was she'd have a grandson who would be a great devotee.
那由于她在正面方面的这种忏悔的礼物呢，所以她又得到好的结果，就是她其中的一个孙子是一个伟大的奉献者。
And that devotee would be Prahlad, who's a great pure devotee of the Lord.
那个孙子呢，就是说我们大家知道主的一个伟大奉献的，就是这个 Prahlad。
And Prahlad is of such a great name, he's so elevated in spiritual consciousness that he doesn't look bad on anybody, even people who try to kill him. Prahlad is very kind to him.
他的这个品格是这么好，即便呢那些试着去杀害他的人，或是协助来要杀害他的那些人们呢，他一点都没有记恨，反而想要也要来拯救他们。
So we go on to the next chapter, chapter 15. It begins with a description about how Diti, when she heard that her two children are going to give trouble to the demigods.She's reluctant to give birth to them, and she keeps them in her womb for 100 years.
然后接着在第十五章继续描述，弟弟听到了说，他的孩子两个孩子会是恶魔呢，所以他很害怕把这两个孩子生出来，就把这个胎儿留在他的这个胚胎里面让他们这里面留了100年。
Very long time to get a child in the womb.
你把小孩放在这么久100年在你的胎里面，所以
But remember, this was in Satya Yuga.
但是要记得这个时候是在 Satya 年代。
And Satya Yuga people had a duration of life of 100,000 years.
在那个 Satya 年代，人类的寿命平均是100,000年的寿命。
And Diti also is not really of this planet, but she's from the higher planet.
那么弟弟呢，他也不是属于这个星球，是在高等星球的。
So she, because she thought if I give birth to my two sons, they'll give trouble to all the demigods. And she didn't want to give trouble. She didn't like her sons giving trouble to the demigods, so she just kept them in her womb.
那么他听到就是说，这个他两个儿子呢，会给这个宇宙带来很多的麻烦。困扰，他不想让他的孩子产生这些问题，所以就把这个胎儿还是继续留在这个胚胎里面。
But the result was that because she was keeping the two sons in her womb, and the two sons were so powerful that it created the darkness in the universe. The light of the sun and the moon was all covered over.
那因为他把这两个胎儿放在胎中，就留在那儿，那两个胎变得非常有力量，那就造成整个宇宙，遍布都是黑暗的。
And when there was no light in the universe, then the demigods couldn't do any work.
那哎，这宇宙已经没有光的话呢，半神人就什么事也做不了。
Everything was stopped. The whole universe was just. Nobody was able to do anything. And the demigods approached Lord Brahma to find out what is going on. Why is the universe so dark?
那半神人就去到 Brahma 面前去探究，说为什么整个宇宙造成这样子呢？
So at that time, Lord Brahma was.He told the demigods about how the four Kumaras had gone to the spiritual world.
那时候啊，就是说到啊，这个四个 Kumara 的那个前面那四个小孩，怎么样已经回到灵性世界
？And so here you see demigods approach Brahma for an explanation, and Brahma explains his son, the four Kumaras, how they have gone into the Vaikuntha.
嗯啊，所以这里面就叙述半神人去到 Brahma 面前呐、啊，那 Brahma 就告诉他这个四个孩子呢啊，他们是怎么样的回到 Vaikuntha 去。
And but when they entered into Vaikuntha, they got through the first six doors of Vaikuntha. They got through the first six doors, but when they came to the seventh door, they were stopped by the two doormen.、嗯
那就接着描述到这些这四个小孩呢，他们也是圣人，那进入了，他们先在白昆达经过了六道门，到了第七道门的时候就被挡住了。
So you can see the four Kumaras that they're naked and they're wearing some garlands and they appear to be like young children, but actually they're the oldest.People in the universe, they're the first sons of Lord Brahma, so they're older even than Lord Shiva.
这四个 Kumara 呢，啊，就像这样的小孩的样子，而且身上没穿的衣服，那他们看起来就像一个很年幼的孩子，但事实上呢，他们是第一列出现的人，所以比那个 Brahma 还要老。
But usually little children, you know, they're given a lot of freedom. Even you see in our temples, you know, they have, when children are there, they'll often let the children just walk around, come around.
一般呢，如果有小孩子过来的话呢，我们给小孩子很大的自由，他们还可以跑来跑去的啦，做一些自己想做的事，这样子。
And similarly, also monks. Monks are also given that kind of freedom. 嗯，
同样的道理，那一些和尚们呢，也是给予这样子的自由。
At least in India, when you wear the saffron cloth, then you're given a lot of freedom.
嗯，啊，如果就是连在印度也是，如果你是穿的这种橘色袈裟的这种。
People won't really stop you. You can go in everywhere.
那啊，你就可以到处自己的去行走，没有人来阻挡你。
So the four Kumaras, they were wandering everywhere. They didn't have any material desires, and because they had no material desires.They were able to enter into the spiritual world.
这个四个 Kumara 呢，啊，他们是没有任何的物质欲望，所以他们可以在这个灵性世界自由的走动。
But they got to the seventh door, and then the giant Vijaya, the two gatekeepers, they're stopping them.
然而呢，他们走到有一些门。门关的时候呢，被这个守门加尔跟加尔的询问挡下来询问。
So the four Kumaras became stated here. They naturally became very angry and sorrowful.
所以在这里描述到这四个 Kumara 自然的就是被这样子被询问啊，又被挡住呢，就变得非常生气，而且很难过。
You could imagine, just like if you come to the temple.
你们就想一想，就像你们来了庙的话。
Right? And somebody said, "No, you can't go in."
有人在门口挡住，说不，你不能进去啊。
You're not qualified.
你没有资格哦。
How will you feel?
你会怎么感觉呢？
So, the four Kumaras.That's what happened to them. The giant Vijaya were saying, "Come on, you're not qualified. How did you get here? You're just just little children, you're not qualified.
就是像这个情况呢，扎尔根比扎尔在门口挡住，说你们只是一些小孩子啊，你们没有资格，你们凭什么呢来这边这样到处走动，还想进来呢？
You come here. So when the four Kumaras were stopped, their eyes suddenly turned red because of anger.
那接着又描述到这四个 Kumara。 他们被这样挡住，那突然间眼睛变得非啊红，很红那种愤怒。The
anger was due to their great eagerness to see their most beloved master, Sri Hari, the personality of Godhead.嗯，他们的愤怒是由于呢，他们急切的去想要见到这个至尊主哈利哈。
是他们最亲爱的主人，他们急切的渴望。So
it's interesting to note here that even in the spiritual world, there can be anger.
嗯，在这里很有趣，很有意思的去知道，甚至在灵世世界都会有愤怒、生气。We
somebody brought this up last night. They asked about people getting angry in the spiritual world.
嗯，昨天有人问起来说，啊，在灵性世界人们的愤怒这些事。But
we should understand their anger was because their devotion to Lord Krishna was being obstructed.
嗯，啊，但我们可以来了解呢，在灵性世界那种愤怒是由于那些急切的对菩萨的父母爱被。
Usually here in this world, we get angry because someone's in the way of our own sense gratification.
一般而言，我们在这个物质世界会愤怒呢，是由于别人挡住了我们的感官享乐。When
we don't get our own, when we don't get to satisfy our senses the way we want, we get angry.
嗯，啊，就是说，哎，人们挡住了我们所想要去得到的时候，我们就生气了。In
fact, it is said that anger is the younger brother of material desire.
啊，是这样说的，啊，愤怒呢是物质欲望的弟弟。
Material desires, the younger brother is anger.
所以物质欲望，他的弟弟就是愤怒、生气。Because
you had the desire to get something, you didn't get it, so you get angry.
嗯，因为你有这个欲望，想要去获得什么，可是没得到呢，就生气了。So
that kind of anger is not good.
这样子的这个生气是不好的。Of
course, anger is not really good. But here you see, in this case, the four Kumaras, their anger is justified because they had that so much, they had that eagerness to come and see the
Lord.
Well, yes, they're still impersonalists at this point, but they're not.
But they know that there is a Supreme Lord.
Yeah, they know, they'd heard about the Lord because they'd heard from Lord Brahma.
嗯，这个四个Kumara他们在这个时候还是没人格的这个概念，但是他们也知道有至尊人格守神，因为他们从这个。
But they were more attracted to the impersonal Brahman at this point. They were. They were more attracted to the impersonal.
所以四个古玛尔在这个阶段还是更加的对这个非人格的范更加的着迷。
So they were fixed more on the impersonal Brahman.
所以他们是比较专注在那个非人格的泛光。
But still, they come to the spiritual world. and they had come to see the Lord.
即便是这样，他们还是来到灵性世界，而且想要见到主。
They'd never seen the Lord before.
他们从来都还没见过主。
So they thought, because they can go, they can travel anywhere. So they came to Vaikuntha. They entered into the gates of Vaikuntha.
因为他们可以四处在灵性世界自由走动，所以他们也可以来到这个无忧心树白昆塔去。
So when they were stopped, they became angry.
所以呢，他们被人家挡住的时候就生气了。
And Srila Prabhupada comments here how anger will continue even in the liberated stage.
他还有继续说到，生气、愤怒，甚至到了解脱的阶段，还是会继续的。
Now the four Kumaras, they're mendicants, fully detached from the material world.
这个四个苦阿尔呢，就是那一种就像这个脱钵修行那样，完全弃绝的修行者。
So they were liberated persons.
而且他们已经是解脱的人了。
But because they were not able to engage to, because their service was being restricted, they became angry.
但是由于他们的服务被人家限制了，所以他们变得生气了。
Yet, how to understand this that?Did they have a desire to do service because they were still impersonalists?
要怎么来了解呢？即便他们还是非人格主义者，但是他们还是有做服务的愿望。
But they've heard about the Lord. They've heard about Him from their father, from Lord Brahma. Somehow they were just more inclined to the impersonal Brahma.
这种情况呢，是他们从父亲 Brahma。半天那边有听到竞争组，但是他们还是比较在人非人格的部分被吸引着。
If you read the book Brihad Bhagavat Amrita, you can read about how Gokumar, the cowherd boy from Govardhan, travels, and he goes one of the places he goes to.Up in the top of the universe is a place called Tapaloka, and the four Kumaras are there.
假如你们有机会来读这个伟大的国家瓦坦甘露吉，然后里面有一个部分描述到这个四个 Kumara 他们来到这个宇宙最高的星球叫 Tapaloka.
Yeah, Tapaloka, right. There's four planets above the heavenly planets, there's four more planets, there's Mahaloka and Janaloka and then Tapaloka and Satyaloka.
所以呢，在这个天堂星宿更高，还有四个星球。
So the top is Satyaloka where Lord Brahma lives.
那么最高的是 Satyaloka, 是
Brahma lives.
Brahma.
And great sages like Bhrigu Muni and so on, they are also living there.
大伟大的圣人啊，像 Bhrigu Muni 啊，他们也住在这个 Satyaloka.
And then down from Satyaloka is this Tapaloka where the four Kumaras are. And the four Kumaras are there and they're engaged in meditation.
然后在 Satya 这个星球，再来是叫做。那就是这个四个 Kumara 他们在那边进行他们修行，那他们是以冥想的方式来进行。
The four Kumaras are in Santara.
四个 Kumara 跟主的关系是在那个 Santarasa 的关系。
Santara means they appreciate the opulences, but they don't engage in service.
就是他们会欣赏的这种。主的富裕，但是他们没有进行服务。
They're attracted by the Lord, but still they don't take up any active service.
他们呢受着主所吸引的，可是他们还没有进行活跃的服务。
So, when Gopkumar goes there, Gopkumar, they, you know, that they're all sitting, they're all doing their meditation, they're all absorbed in their meditation.
所以在这个伟大的国家网站甘露经里面描述这个有一个牧牛头叫 Gopakumara 他就是一层一层的星球这样去拜访然后他来到这个 Tapa Loka 的时候见到这四个Kumara正在做冥想
And Gopakumara has a big discussion with them about what's better to do meditation or to do some other process of self-healing
那这个 Gopakumara 就跟这个四个 Kumara 在讨论着，就是说什么样是最好的冥想方式啊，等等等这类的讨论。
It's also mentioned that the four Kumaras, there's one purport by Prabhupada in the third canto, where he talks about how sometimes even Lord Brahma and even the four Kumaras may not be pure devotees and they may not go back to Godhead.
In the third canto,
So sometimes anyway, it happens that the four Kumaras are not able to go back to God. Anyway, here in this passage which is being described in relation to Lord Varaha, the four Kumaras have gone to the spiritual world and they got angry at the two
gatekeepers.
So it's the nature of the four Kumaras that they were fixed in self-realization. They were not fully devotees, but they were fixed in self-realization. They'd understood themselves not to be the body. They had no conception of theirs and ours. You know, we think this is mine, this is his, this is hers, this is mine. What's mine and what's somebody else's? They have no idea of that. What belongs to someone, what doesn't belong to somebody.
这个四个Kumara他们冥想到达的阶段是他们完全的自我觉悟很坚定地处在他们自我觉悟的状态那个冥想里面但是他们还没有更高层的领悟比如说拥有者
是谁的，是这些是你的，我的，他的，还是什么？他们还没有这一些区分，只是知道自己不是这个物质身体，是灵性身份。So the four Kumaras, they thought, how is it that these two men, two doorkeepers, are stopping us from entering into Vaikuntha.
那他们没有那种相对概念，就是碰到的时候就想，为什么这个两个守门人，在Vaikuntha这个守门的人还可以阻挡我们呢？为什么他要阻挡我们进去？
How is it possible any imposters or anybody who is unqualified could come to Vaikuntha and enter, come to the gates of Vaikuntha? To come to the gates of Vaikuntha, we must be qualified. How is it these two men are blocking our way?
就是说，已经有资格来到这个Vaikuntha，已经是灵性的阶段了。那这个两个守门人怎么可以说我们没有资格来进去呢？
So the four Kumaras were. They thought these two gatekeepers, they must be imposters. They cannot be the real residents of Vaikuntha. A resident of Vaikuntha wouldn't think like this.
So,
because they're thinking the Kumaras are enemies, they're blocking them from entering the spiritual world. How is it possible any enemies could ever enter into the spiritual world?
这两个守门者认为这个库马尔就像是这个维昆塔的敌人，那敌人可怎么可能进入到这个灵性世界呢？
So the four Kumaras considered that this giant Vijay are not behaving in the mood of Vaikuntha.
So these four Kumaras
they're not in harmony with the Vaikuntha mood. So we should understand the nature of Vaikuntha. But Vaikuntha is a very different realm from the material world. It's important for us to have a very great fascination for Vaikuntha or the spiritual world, and we should want very much to go there.
所以我们应该对于这个维昆塔或者灵性世界有极大的这种渴望，那种梦想，就是非常急切的想要到维昆塔去，想要去到灵性世界。
Just like people, they often have a fascination to go to somewhere like America.
就像有一些人呢，会特别的向往去到美国啦，或者是非常向往去到哪里。
You know, sometimes young people, when they're working to get scholarships or go to great extents, they want so much to enter into a prestigious Western university.
有些时候就像有些年轻人呢，他们同学之间互相鼓励的，造成一种风潮，就想说在学术上有一个成就啊，那他们就大家非常的向往啊，比方西方国家的某某有名的大学啊，去那边得到学位这些事情。People
have very strong desires, so we should have a desire also to go to Vaikuntha.
所以人们有强烈的欲望。 所以我们也应该有强烈的欲望的想到去到Vaikuntha。
So what is that mode of Vaikuntha? What happens there?
那在Vaikuntha它的心境还有它的氛围是怎么样？那边在发生或进行什么事？
First of all, we should understand that in Vaikuntha, there's no old age, there's no disease, and there's no death.
首先我们必须要知道，在Vaikuntha那边没有 年老啦，没有衰老、死亡这一些疾病。
Everyone has a spiritual body.
每个人都是有个灵性的这个躯体。
And you can see Jai and Vijay, how their bodies they have four arms. And this is common for the residents of Vaikuntha.
那我们看这个守门的Jai跟Vijay，他们是有四只手背的。那在Vaikuntha这是很稀松平常，在那边的居民一般都是四只手背。And
their skin, you can see that bluish, dark bluish color, like the green cloud.
而且看到他们肤色呢，就像我们
And because there's no old age there, they're the same age. Everyone in the spiritual world is of the same age.
那因为没有衰老、没有老龄这件事，所以在维昆塔的每一个人呢，都是同年龄的。
We see Lord Krishna when Lord Krishna appeared in this world 5,000 years ago, that He took a baby form and he grew up to the young youthful form, and he never grew past that. He remained in that form for more, although he was on the planet for 120 years, but still he never grew old.
那我们也看着呢，Krishna在这个地球显现的时候。 他先从一个小婴儿这样的出现，然后又长，慢慢长，长到一个青年的样子。可是从青年之后，他的身体都没有再变老，就是一直到他在地球上的125年的时候，都一样的那种青春。
So in the spiritual world, there's no old age or disease or death.
所以在灵性世界，没有这种老年啊、疾病啊。衰退这一些症状。
No COVID
没有病毒感染，没有疫情。
None of these nasty things.
没有那些
vaccination.
没有我们物质世界，没有物质世界的疫情灾难。人们非常渴望去那里。
So that's one aspect of the spiritual world. Also.It's in the spiritual world, you should understand that everything is of the absolute nature, and there's no difference between plants and animals and human beings.
No difference in which way?
They're absolute, is all living entities are of an absolute nature. There's no difference in their consciousness.
那么在灵性世界，因为没有生老病死这些事情，在灵性世界，不管是动物啦、植物啦、任何生物，他们都是绝对的。绝对的意思是说，他们是在处在那种超然知觉的那种绝对的状态。
The all different forms of life are there in the spiritual world.But they're all of supreme pure consciousness.
在灵性世界，就说各种生物的形体啊都存在的，但是他们都是在于这种超然灵性的知觉。
They're all pure devotees.
不管是什么样形体的生物，在灵性世界的这些生物都是纯粹的奉献。
All the living entities.The animals and the plants and all the everything, all the everything there is, they're all pure devotees. They're simply in the mood of doing service for the Supreme.
所以在灵性世界，不管什么生物、动物、植物，所有一切都是纯洁的奉献者，纯洁的灵魂。那他们知觉就是要来为主服务。
And then also in the spiritual world, there are wonderful trees called desire trees.
那在灵性世界也有一种非常美妙的树，叫做如愿树。
And here in this world, you know, you wait for the mango season to come, and you get the mangoes at a particular time in the year. But in the spiritual world, in Vaikuntha.You can get the trees and the flowers and the fruits any time of the year.
那我们在这个物质世界啊，如果说了你要得到芒果，你必须等到一年的某一个时段哈，芒果盛产的季节，而且在那季节内的某个时候是它成熟的时候才可以摘取到芒果。可是，在灵性世界呢，所有的植物如果想愿，是什么样的果实、什么样的花，在任何的时候都可以出现。
So the trees are all cultivation trees, and the cows are Kamadhenu cows, and they fulfill all desires also.
所以灵性世界的这些树也都是如愿树、愿望树。在灵性世界，这些乳牛呢，就是 Kamadhenu 哈，这个乳牛。
And even the dust in the spiritual world is Chintamani.
然后在灵性世界，这个地上所有的尘土都是这个点金石 Chintamani.
And the specific nature of the spiritual world is there's no rajas and tamas there. It's only pure goodness.
而在灵性世界，所有的氛围的存在，没有任何的激情的属性，也没有愚昧属性，都是完全是 纯粹的善良。
The mode of passion, the mode of ignorance is not there at all. Every, all in the Vaikuntha is all pure goodness.
嗯，在灵性世界，一点也不存在积极属性，也没有愚昧属性。在 Vaikuntha 这样子是完全的纯粹的善良。
But at the same time, although pure goodness is, there was still anger could be there.
即便是说在纯粹的善良状态里面，还是有这个愤怒、生气的存在。
That anger was not of the mode of passion or fear.
在那里的愤怒、生气不是激情或是愚昧那些属性的。
It was in relation to devotional self.
他们那边的愤怒生气是跟奉爱服务相关联的。
So the two gatekeepers, the four Kumaras consider these two gatekeepers are not qualified to be in Vaikuntha.
那个四个 Kumara 的就认为这两个这个守门者呢，不没有资格留在 Vaikuntha 那儿。
Because they are finding duality.In the existence of Vaikuntha life.
他们认为这两个人呢，在 Vaikuntha 的生活存在里，还存着这种相对二元性。
What is the duality? Well, they're saying the four Kumaras are not qualified. You're not qualified to come here. Other people, you're qualified, you're not qualified. So they're seeing duality.
这就是为什么说有这个二元性呢？因为这两个守门就说四个 Kumara 没有资格进来，所以四个 Kumara 给他们争论回去，就说你们就是在看人有没有资格没资格，就是一种相对存在的，所以他们认为这两个守门没有资格，因为他们会去这样把人分类。
But Vaikuntha life is pure without any contamination.
但是在 Vaikuntha 里面的生活是纯洁纯粹，没有任何的污染。
But these two giant Vijay, they must be contaminated, so they don't belong here. They should go to the material.
因为在 Vaikuntha 是纯粹的，没有那种相对性，所以他们认为这 giant Vijay 呢，已经把这样子分类了，有资格没资格，就表示他们呢，他们是已经被污染的，所以不没有资格留在 Vaikuntha 了。
So this is the four Kumaras are releasing their anger against the two. Mm-hmm.
所以是这个四个 Kumara 就把他们的愤怒发出来，就认为这两个守门人竟然这样子的去。
So Srila Prabhupada comments about this Vaikuntha harmony here.
所以 Prabhupada 就来阐述的在 Vaikuntha 里面的和谐。
He says if the members of ISKCON put faith in Krishna as the center and live in harmony according to the order and principles of Bhagavad Gita, then they're living in Vaikuntha, not in this material world.
然后他说，在国际昆山知觉学会里面的成员呢，对昆山存有信心把昆山就是对这种信心是为中心，然后是非常和谐的住在一起，根据这个国家梵歌里面的命令跟原则，这样子的话，他们就是居住在Vaikuntha，而不是在物质世界。
Srila Prabhupada would sometimes point out that.This temple is not in Taipei, but it's in the spiritual world.
方法经常指出，就像我们说，这个庙呢，不是在台北，而是在灵性世界。
But we have to create also that atmosphere of the spiritual world.
这么说，但我们也必须要创造这样灵性世界的氛围。
And Prabhupada mentioned some points which are important. We must first of all have faith in Lord Krishna as the center.
那 Prabhupada 提出的要点就是我们首先必须把 Krishna 作为我们生活的中心，对 Krishna 的信心。
This is mentioned in the Ishopanishad about the Ishavasya society having God in the center.
那么这一点呢，在至尊奥义书的前头开头有说到，就是要把神 是为一切的中心。
And then live in harmony according to the order and principles of Bhagavad Gita.
嗯，而且根据博迦梵歌的这个命令还有原则来和谐的相处居住。
What are the order and principles of Bhagavad Gita? Well, the order is to surrender to Krishna.
那博迦梵歌里面的命令跟原则是什么呢？那个命令呢，就是说来向 Krishna 臣服。
The principles of Bhagavad Gita are recognizing, first of all, we're not the material body, we're spirit souls.
嗯，那博迦梵歌的原则是什么呢？就是首先我们要辨认出我们不是这个物质身体，我们是灵性的灵魂。
And recognizing others also as being spirit souls, seeing them not as being the material body.
嗯，而且这个原则也包括，就是说去看待别人也是个灵性的灵魂，而不是这个物质的躯体。
We shouldn't have prejudice. In other words, we shouldn't be prejudiced against.I don't like this person, or I don't like that kind of people. We shouldn't have any particular feelings about what we like and what we don't like, but rather we should see everyone equally.
我们不应该有那种虚假的威望，啊，我喜欢这人，我不喜欢那个人啊，这个人怎么样，那个人怎么样。我们是应该平等的去这样看待所有的。
If we think, oh, he's not qualified for Krishna consciousness, or we don't want him to come to Krishna
consciousness.
We should see every living entity as a spiritual particle and try to help them progress in Krishna consciousness.
嗯，我们应该看着所有的生物呢，都是 Krishna 的所属的部分，而且他们都有机会来服务 Krishna。
And we see in Chaitanya Charitamrita how Shivananda Singh gave nursing to a dog to help even the dog. He saw the dog was attached to the devotees, and he encouraged the dog and took care of the dog and arranged prasadam for the dog.
我们在永恒的 Chaitanya 经有看到的，像 Shivananda Singh 啊。他是怎么样的？他非常依附于有一只狗，然后他就照顾那条狗，然后给这条狗这个像其他不杀的啊等等。
And when they had to cross on a ferry, then the boatman didn't want to let the dog on the boat, but Shivananda Singh gave some money to the boatman so that the dog also could come on the boat and cross the river and keep stay with the party.
那么这个十万人的 Sena 他要去参加唱诵队伍，必须坐船过河。可是船夫呢不允许那条狗上去，啊，那这个十万人的 Sena 就付一点钱给船夫，让这条狗一起去参加那边的唱诵。
So we do want to think about trying to create harmony in Krishna consciousness.
所以我们也是要试的，在 Krishna 知觉的里面呢，来创造和谐。
We know the symptom of the age of Kali is quarrel, argument, and a lot of conflicts between people.
嗯，我们知道呢，卡利年代的一个特征是什么？就是说，纷争、争吵，人们很多的矛盾冲突。嗯
，Sometimes.We make a little molehill into a mountain.
就是这个拿鸡毛当令箭啊，小吹毛求疵，搞得一团乱。
But we want to make the mountain to the molehill.
我们就想说大事化小，小事化无这样子。
We shouldn't, in other words, we shouldn't get too much disturbed when people start disagreeing, when there's conflicts and disagreements, but we should understand that this is due to our lack of Krishna consciousness.
所以我们呢应该了解，我们不应该那么受到其他的所谓对我们的反对啦，或是说其他的批评感到受困扰。我们必须要了解，就是说我们在 Krishna 知觉的。进步程度所造成的情况。
We can we can create the harmonious atmosphere by increasing our level of Krishna consciousness.
我们可以怎么样创造和谐的氛围呢？就是增加自己的 Krishna 知觉。
And that means increasing our hearing and chanting and our absorption in Krishna's service.
这就是我们来增加我们的聆听、念受、更专注于对 Krishna 的服务。
And why is there conflicts? Why is there this disharmony amongst devotees? It is due to our forgetfulness of Krishna.
那为什么在奉献者之中有那么多会有冲突啦、矛盾啊、不和谐啊？那是由于我们忘记了 Krishna.
Sometimes people want to give up association with devotees, but we should know if you have to give, if you go away from the association with devotees, then it will be very difficult to make spiritual advancement.
有些时候呢，有一些人会想说，脱离跟奉献者的联谊交流。但是呢，如果真正跟奉献者的联谊脱离的话，要灵性的进步是很困难的。To
make advancement, we need association. Our advancement depends 96% on association.
所以灵修要进步就。 需要有奉献者的联谊，我们在灵性上的进步，96%是建立于跟奉献者的联谊里面。96%，96%，对，96%，98%，96%，96%，96%。
So very important, don't get disturbed when there's conflicts among devotees.
所以这是非常重要，在奉献者之中有发生的差异啊、冲突、矛盾的时候，不要被干扰。
Try to help them to increase their Krishna consciousness.
要试着帮忙他们哈，调整他们在 Krishna 境界里面和谐。
Srila Prabhupada says here from his purport, in the spiritual world, this religious principle of Krishna consciousness is maintained in harmony. So that world is called Vaikuntha.
因此，那样的世界是称为白昆塔，没有忧愁的。
And if the same principles can be adopted here, wholly or partially, then it is also
Vaikuntha。那如果这些相同的原则能够在这里啊接受的话呢，不管是全部的被接受或是部分的，那这些地方也是白昆塔。
So it is with any society. Such as ISKCON.
那这个原则是在所有的协会团体都是一样，就例如这我们的 ISKCON 也是。
So we want to have a happy, harmonious atmosphere.
所以我们是想要有这个快乐和谐的氛围。
That is actually the nature of the spiritual world.
啊，这种快乐和谐的氛围是。 灵性世界的这个本质。But
if we allow Kali Yuga to enter into our midst, then we start to quarrel and argue, and all of our time is wasted.
那如果说我们的允许这个卡利进来的话，奉献者在那边吵架争论的话呢，这就是卡利。
And this is very common in the age of Kali. Age of Kali symptomized by quarrel over stupid things, over meaningless issues.
对，那个情况就是很卡利的特征了，就是说，人们为了微不足道的小事在那边争辩、吵架。
So here you can see, the four Kumaras were there at the gate, and then just at that moment, when their way was blocked by the two gatekeepers, at that moment, Lord Padmanabha, who is a name of Lord Narayan, he came there with his associate.
当这个四个Kumara被挡在这个白昆达门口的时候，这个主的另外一个化身呢，Padmanabha出现了，他跟他的同伴一起来到这里。
You can see that Lord Narayan is there with his consort, the goddess of fortune, and then also you can see Garuda is also there.
啊，我们看到图片呢，就主这个。
Narayana跟他的这个同伴呢，幸运女神呢，还有这个啊，他的，嗯，what's
the name？
Garuda。So they've come there to see the four Kumaras, and the four Kumaras are able to see the beautiful form of Lord Narayana.
所以呢，他们一起来到这四个 Kumara 的前面前呢。
And then the Srimad Bhagavatam gives us this nice verse describing what happened to the four Kumaras.
那佛教瓦藤里面也描述了这个四个Kumara接着发生的情况。
Tashya Ravinda Nayanashya Padaravinda Kinjau Kamishra Talasi Makaranda Vayu Anandhagata Swabhugarena Chakara Tesham Sanshobha Makshara Jasham Apichitta Tango. Translation. When the breeze carrying the aroma of tosi leaves from the toes of the lotus feet of the Lord entered the nostrils of those sages, they experienced a change from impersonal to personal understanding.
所以这里就是刚那一段的这个说明哈，当这个土拉西树叶的芳香由这个微风带进来。 那么从主的莲花组里面，把这土拉西的芬芳这样传出来，进入了这些圣人们的鼻孔里面，那这些圣人们就惊艳到从非人格的状态转变成人格状态的了解。So
here you have an example of impersonalists becoming devotees.
所以这里就有一个例子，就是说啊，非人格主义者变成人格主义者，就是奉献者。The
four Kumaras were never offenders. They were never Mayavadi.
这个四个 Kumara 虽然是非人格主义者，但是他们不是假象宗，他们不是冒犯者。The
Mayavadis, they will deny the personal form.
这个假象宗人士呢，他们是。
But the four Kumaras, they had heard about the Lord, and they had come there to the spiritual world desiring to see Him. They were mainly fixed on the impersonal Brahman.
四个Kumara呢，他们有听到这个关于主的人格特征，但虽然他们还是自己专注在。 这个泛光的这个部分，但是他们有这个欲望，想要见到主的人格特形体。Because
they were engaged in that kind of meditation, so practicing that path of meditation is common for people to go towards the impersonal feature.
因为这个古玛尔他们在进行的是冥想。 那冥想是一般让人们容易进到非人格范的方式。People
find it easier to accept the impersonal feature than the personal feature.
人们呢，觉得要进到非人格的这种情况呢，是比进到人格里面的情况更容易。
And the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna also describes like that.
在国家梵歌里面 ，Krishna 也有描述这样子的情况。
Manusya nam sahasrishu kaschidya tati siddhaye。Manusya nam sahasrishu kaschidya tati siddhaye。Yata dhamma pisada nam kaschimam veti tattva。So Lord Krishna is saying, out of thousands of men, hardly one is endeavoring for perfection。
所以在这里面 ，Krishna 说，在数千人中，很少数人啊去得到完美。
So that manusha kaschidya tati siddhaye, they've come to understand the impersonal feature。
那这些人呢，他们来到了就是说主的非人格层面的了解。
And of those who've achieved perfection, who've realized that impersonal feature.Hardly one knows me in truth。
那么在那么多个到达非人格的领悟的人，还是很少数人可以真正的了解我原来的本质。
Just like here in Taiwan, we find a lot of people who are impersonal。
就好像我们在台湾也啊看到很多人是非人格主义者。
Maybe the Buddhist method of meditation。
或是啊，像佛教人士啊，在进行冥想的人啊。
Then you've got people like Ananda Marga also。
还有另外一些人是 Ananda Marga 那一些团体的。
They do the impersonal meditation。
他们做的是非人格的冥想。
And for anybody who has a little interest in self-realization。It's they're more inclined towards impersonalism.
所以平均来说，对于自我觉悟有兴趣的人，他们一般是倾向于非人格的啊这种境界，非人格的倾向。
It's everywhere.
那这是处处都普遍的现象。
The books, the teachings of all these people, all over the world.
这些非人格领悟的层面的说明啊，这些书籍啊，在世界各地泛滥着。
But Prabhupada wanted to, he trying to give Prabhupada's mission is to give the personal understanding.
那 Prabhupada 的使命呢，就是要给人们对这个人格。人格性的这些了解。
So we say Gauravani Pracharine is preaching the message of Lord Chaitanya.
我们在对明镜导师的祈祷文其中是 Gauravani Pracharine， 就是说把这个主的讯息，主 Chaitanya 的讯息传遍全世界。
Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatadisa。And Lord Chaitanya's teaching is to defeat these two philosophies, Nirvisesha and Shunyavada, which is impersonalism and voidism.
这主 Chaitanya 的出现呢，就是要来这个摧毁这个一个是虚无主义者，还有一个
非人格
的一个虚无主义者，Nirvisesha Shunyavada。
So there was a change. The four Kumaras, when the Lord appeared to them, the aroma of the tulsi leaves from the lotus, just that smell, the fragrance of the tulsi leaves from the lotus feet entered into their nostrils. And it brought about the change in their consciousness.
所以呢，四个苦玛拉就有这样的改变，仅仅是从主的这个莲花竹上的这土拉斯叶子的香气，就进到他们的鼻孔，然后就让他们整个知觉改变，从非人格的这种概念转变成人格的了解。
We're given another example of an impersonalist who became a devotee, that of Sukadeva Goswami.
我们要来说另外一个例子，从非人格主义者转变成人格主义者，就是 Sukadeva Goswami。
He was an impersonalist. He was fixed on the impersonal Brahman. But when he heard the Srimad Bhagavatam, then he became attracted.
他呢，先前是说是非人格主义者，他就是专注在这个非人格的范。那当他这个。 这个在佛教瓦台这个描述里面它就转变了。
So the impersonal, the impersonalist can be brought to the personal understanding by some kind of devotional service.
所以在非人格主义认识的层面呢，可以转变到是人格性的认识的领悟的层面，就是经由奉爱服务的部分。
One stroke of devotional service can just take away all their impersonal understanding.
仅仅是奉爱服务的一根稻草，就可以把非人格主义的这样去除了，进入人格特质。
So we've spoken about the main points of this chapter and the features of the Vaikuntha planets.
So we've talked about this chapter's topic,
how the Vaikuntha planets are completely pure goodness, no influence of passion and ignorance.
就是麦昆塔的星球那里是纯粹的善良属性，没有任何激情或愚昧。
There's no old age, disease or death.
在那里没有所谓年老啦、疾病啦、死亡这些事情。
And there's an atmosphere of perfect harmony, cooperation in the service of the Supreme Lord.
而在那儿的范围呢，是氛围是完全的和谐的。服务的主啊，就是很合作和谐的这样服务的主。
So we spoke about how the Kumaras, their impersonalism was brought to personalism by devotional service. So the same way we try to influence also the impersonalists, give them the opportunity to also engage in some devotional service.
我们说到这个四个 Kumara 从非人格的这种概念转变到这个人格的概念的面呢，就是经由奉献服务。所以呢，我们也希望呢，用这样的方式让人们有机会去进行奉爱服务，而成为人格主义。
And we spoke about disharmony, material disharmony. Everywhere in the world today, there's so much disharmony, conflicts, one nation against another.One community against another. Even in the family, you've got disharmony. So we want to remove all that disharmony and to create spiritual harmony.
那在我们知道现在的世界呢，社会上处处都是很多的冲突啊、矛盾啊、不和谐啊。所以呢，我们想要就是说，不管是在国家之间呐、或是社区之间，甚至家庭里面呢，很多都充满着矛盾、冲突、争执这些事情。但是我们要把这一种冲突、争执去除，来变得和谐的。
Material life will always be there will always be conflicts and problems. We want to create spiritual atmosphere.
物质生活总是处处有的问题、麻烦啊、冲突啊，但是我们想要来创造出的灵性的氛围。
And that spiritual atmosphere is made very easy, very possible for all of us simply by.Chanting the holy name and reading scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam.
那要产生灵性的氛围是很容易的方式，就是说我们来念诵这个圣名啊，研究经典，像佛家瓦坛啊，这样子的服务，然后创造出这种灵性的氛围。
And taking the shelter and association of the devotees and Krishna.
然后呢，脱离一个奉献者的涟漪，这样子。
Okay, any questions?
有没有任何问题
？Yes, Loka Bandhu Prabhu,
Parati. 由于今天晚上上这个四个 Kumara， 我在这边自首，我将近五年没有到庙里来的原因。
You mentioned about four Kumara and he's giving us why he didn't come for 5 years in the association. 5 years, he didn't come to the temple.
Oh.
He's going to speak about it.
这五年，虽然没有到庙里面来，但是在疫情发生前，俄罗斯的马达举来台湾只能待留一个月，所以这个 America Virasini 他就请我帮他们做面包，第一次我就六条通通送给他们，然后第二次、第三次。那现在就是说我为什么这五年来没有来，就在2018年的晚上10月21号，我站在那个是什么罗雷塔那个是什么修帕马塔吉的儿子的旁边，他们在传递这个水跟火的时候，他就避开我了。那我心里想说，我是这么堕落吗？所以我就不跟你来了。
Before the pandemic, 2018, there were some Russian devotees stay here for to distribute books, and Amrita Virasini asked him to make bread for them, and he made bread for them for a few times, and he feel he is doing service. But then. After there was once in the RT, the fever supplied water to everyone, spread. And somehow the person bring the fire, not just how say, go by him, didn't give to him to touch and the water also. So he feel being seriously neglected. He feel he's not like not a part of the yatra. Because he feel his heart also together with other while this moment I was not included, so then he decided not to come.
So what did he say about Shopa?
Oh, Shopa's son happened stand next to him, and they gave to him to this Lavin, but didn't give to him. So he feel he was neglected. He said, "Am I so unqualified or what? Why not? Why I don't have this share?" But the person may not come every week, they got to share, you know? Sometimes it happens like that.
It's not that. Everyone gets it, yeah.
Yeah, but he didn't get it that time. The person may sometime may be too busy, ignore, or I don't know, whatever. So he feels he's being excluded. He feels his mood, his heart, is part of this yatra. Is one of the members, but why people neglect him? In that kind of connection.
It tell him it could be an accident, you know. That person may not have meant it, you know.
我不是在责怪这个人，我是一直深深的自我反省，我是不是这么堕落，所以我的出现就会遮蔽了大家的眼睛。
好像不是故意的吗？好像不是故意的。
啊？
你的人。
我现在故意不故意我不知道了，因为当天晚上我就站在修帕的儿子旁边。
一般可能偶尔会忽略，
因为
人多挤来挤去的。
他不是故意的。
But he said he tried to be introspective. Maybe he's really too fallen. His coming will disturb others, so then he didn't come.
No, no.
所以，这五年来，月亮昌佐尔宝布来台湾。然后这个 Krishna Paradev 可能也不会去问起这个人怎么没来了。以前那个是谁？那个是嘛？那个 Sakitan Babu 已经到大陆去，偶尔请他回来支援的时候，他会打电话给我，他说是不是有人冒犯你？我也跟他讲说没有，因为我有时候脚受伤我就没来了，都是很单纯的。所以在疫情的时候。Amrita Virasini 有一次活动他就请求给我一个机会来，所以有人就讲说洛卡班杜已经离开这个庙了，所以我就想说他这样子的话我始终我就不敢再踏进这个庙里面来。
since during pandemic, Amrita Vishwasini also one festival told him to come. And then he overheard somebody, some devotee say, oh, he's already out. So then he feel discouraged. He said, okay, you don't see me as one of the member. Then he didn't feel inspired to come.
不，这个事情我们在我们的群组里面是我有表达过我的内心的感受，但是因为他们说英文的，他们也没有去看，所以他可能也不了解到底是发生了什么事。
你说你有表达什么感受，在哪里表达？
就我们群组啊。
群组。
对啊。
He said he ever expressed himself in the group, Chinese group, devotee, Taipei group. But maybe the devotee who read English didn't know that he had expressed, he didn't feel he cared, so he didn't feel inspired. Because even here, some very senior devotee here didn't even ask why he didn't come.
所以最近吞咖啡的啊马塔举他透过灵性导师想跟我通话，那因为我怕说我的表达没有办法完全让灵性导师知道，所以我就没有这个建立这个微信，所以就跟灵性导师这个是什么对话
哪个通感
那个
When you care, Tunga Vidya, I will invite him to talk with you in the phone. And he's afraid that if he didn't express well, he may not, have comprehended. So he has withdrawn himself.He fears he couldn't express properly that Maharaj don't understand. So he withdraw himself. You know, sometimes people feel too shy.
Like now or before?
Just recently.
No.
This night.
Just now. No.
Before.
我们灵性导师在我启迪的时候哈，几个训示哈，第一个就是四个规范守则，第二，不能这个是什么冒犯庙里面的领导。好，然后这个是有时候是什么？这个包括每一天要阅读两个小时的这个书籍。那我就想说，这个是所谓的冒犯哈。其实我在庙里面哈，可能是最大的冒犯就是冒犯的这个姆坤达，因为他当时在做神像供奉的时候啊。我的想法是夫妻最好是拜同一个灵性导师，所以我就把他的灵性导师的照片把它拿下来，后来我心里想说，其实我不知道这个事情，后来是什么这个巴曼纳马塔吉有给我打电话，但是我内心也很愧疚，所以说所以是什么这个刚刚我们就讲说是什么不能冒犯我们庙里面的领导。那我是有时候是什么？其实应该其他都很单纯呐、啊，所以我的感觉就是说，上一次这个的传递灯跟水的时候，我的感受就是说，难道我是这么多堕落吗？我这么的污秽吗？所以我就不敢在庙里面来了。
March 听得懂啊。
听得懂啊？
听得懂啊？
听不懂？
听得懂。
听得懂。
所以应该回来。
好，应该回来。
呀呀呀！我
的内心很脆弱了，所以我是晚上，我其实第一天晚上我带便当来哈、啊， 已经零五五分钟要上课，所以我就是晚上睡觉前两个小时我不吃东西，所以我就搭车子到中华路去再吃那个便当。之后呢，我就在这个华盛公园旁边吃，因为我来了，我就想等于说跟大家抢饭吃，所以我就没有那个勇气。
下次不要这样，
稍
微
再
下来，
吃完再回去。你说的是在讲课之前
在
外面吃啊？你先 usually doesn't eat two hours before sleeping, and he also fear.He's afraid that he comes here to take other devotees' share. The prasadam may have already divided to 10 people. If he comes, it becomes extra. So he feels he's burdening others. So he brings his own prasadam box and eat outside before coming. Because he feels if he's too fallen, he's unqualified, he's disturbing others, burdening others. So he tries to take care of himself.
In that idea. 你应该吃菩萨的。
是应该，是应该，但是没那个勇气啊。
真的，
没那个勇气。因为我们这里充很多，不要担心。
你吃，你吃的不多、啊你。你不需要吃很多，你可以吃一点呀、啊。
所以，
如果你不吃菩萨的，你是不好，你是不礼貌。
灵性
来的庙，你应该吃菩萨的。
哦，
你一定要。
不
啊、你不需要吃很多，你可以吃
一
点。可是一定要。
我来拜见灵性导师当天中午哈，这个保护他有传了一份哈，还有包括礼拜天哈，因为我也不好意思跑掉，所以灵性导师来之前哈，碰咖啡底啊，跟那个是什么？Amerita Virasini 还有那个是什么 Bhakta Priya 他就给我传简讯，他说要回来啊。
灵性导师来的要来是这个意思
啊？对对对，
通知的邀请。
所以现在就是说，刚刚我们在讲到昌爪宝夫 Krishna Baldev 啊，他们这些说英文的可能也不完全了解我们说台这个说国语的这些台湾人的这种状况，啊，这些人怎么跑掉了，不回来了，啊，我们台湾的奉献者，好像也没有人去把他拉一把。
在我所知道里面，月亮多少会顺口问几个人。但是有时候那些人不知道，他也无从着手。
也许语言上的问题哈、啊，所以那个什么，那个萨基坦法布他会打电话啊，问我说是不是有人冒犯你，还是怎么样？你怎么没回来，还是怎么样啊？那因为，所以我刚刚就讲说是什么，在昌爪法布跟 Krishna Baldev 的眼光，我已经被判死刑了。
I have some question. Can you talk to
me? Sorry, Maharaj, can we arrange your meeting with him alone sometime?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Okay.
So, you know, Mom, she has jail man. You can come with jail man, Mom. You can language in time.
Maharaj, 个别
来看您什么时间有时间，我跟您没什么，请您训示。
好，我们安排时间。
I read somewhere there's this gates, you said the Kumaras, they were stopped at the gates, so there were seven gates or something. Is it true?
Yeah.
I mean, we don't read in Bhagavatam like that.
That's in the Bhagavatam.
It's in the Bhagavatam. But each gate kind of says something. There's a meaning, there's a symbol for each gate or something like that. Is it true?
I don't know. I don't know what the significance of each of these gates are.
So they managed to cross the six gates and they were stopped at the seven gates.
Yeah. But we're not told there were any gatekeepers at the other gates. You don't know. Come through.
But there are gates. There should be some gatekeepers.
The only gatekeepers we see here about are Jain Vijay, right? We don't hear about any other doorkeepers.
他问说不叫瓦塔，结果刚刚讲到那个Vaikuntha的这个门呢，刚刚说第六、第七个门，但是每一个门好像有一个代表什么。马尔说我们没有读到关于其他的门，而且其他门的守门者是谁，所以不知道每一个门代表的特征。我们读到只有在这个门是 Jaya 跟 Vijaya 这个情况。
Yesterday, we also mentioned about this, the anger in the spiritual world. They also mentioned that, and there's also a symptom that when this demonic person appears in this world, there will be disaster, calamity. And we know that there are so many conflict, fighting in this material world.And because we heard a statement that this material world is a reflection of the spiritual world, so the fighting, the world is origin from the spiritual world or not?
The what?
The fighting, the wars,
war
originate from the spiritual world or not? In the material world, so many conflicts.
But we're hearing about the harmony of the spiritual world. The nature of Vaikuntha is the atmosphere of harmony, not that there's wars and conflicts in the spiritual world.
我们听到就是说，在灵性世界，Vaikuntha的氛围是和谐的，而不是打斗争战的情况。
And if you want wars, there's always war between demigods and the demons. The Asuras and the Devas are always fighting. There's always that conflict.
那如果说要战争的话，总是有这些天人跟恶魔交战，哈 ，Asura 跟 Deva 一直在打战，是存在的。
So there's a conflict between the devotees. The Devas are the devotees, and the Asuras are the non-devotees.
对，跟半神人跟恶魔的代表就是奉献者跟非奉献者的争执争斗。
But the spiritual world, there's no war.
灵性世界里面没有战争。
And there are no demons.
也没有恶魔。
But sometimes there's the rumors.
但是有时候会好像有一种谣言，说啊那边有恶魔什么的，是不是？
我问一个很幼稚的问题，就是 Krishna 的徒弟不是有很多记号吗？对，我的女儿想知道，她是只有在物质世界才有这个记号，还是她在灵性世界也是有这个走路也有这个记号？
We heard that Krishna's the footstool has many signs.And in spiritual world, Krishna's footstool also still have the sign? only when he appeared in the material world.
No, the spiritual is the same.
在灵性世界也是一样，他脚的一半还是有那些特征。
Devotees all should meditate on these different auspicious signs on the soles of the feet
of Krishna.
You see in the temples, when you go to temples, they have the lotus feet of Krishna. They have the, with all the marks on them, you can see.
有些时候，怎么样？你会看到Krishna的那个莲花组的脚印，那脚印就会啊，弄出Krishna的那些特征啊，罗啦，莲花什么这些。Krishna's
body is spiritual.
Krishna身体是灵性的。So
everything is eternal.
所以他的一切都是永恒的。
Okay, Hare Krishna, Shri 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 Shri
Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri
Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri
Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri
Shri Shri Shri Shri
Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri Shri
Shri Shri Shri Shri
Thank you.